Enjoy some great boxing history here on iRAP TV.
I'm Azumah Nelson. You're watching iRAP TV. Don't change the channel.
Tell you that I like the way you're moving.
Yeah,
girl, love the way you're grooving. If you keep on dancing, then my marriage is gonna be ruined.
Catch me in the VIP.
Hi, my name is Yaw Sakyi. I know this is not a regular face you see on iRAP TV. Well, because we bring to you an exclusive interview with Africa's legend, the only professor in boxing. Ladies and gentlemen, brace yourself for this exclusive interview with Professor Azumah Nelson. He is in the state. What is his mission here? We'll tell you when we come back from this break.
Shorty, how you doing? I came over to tell you that I like the way you're moving.
Yeah,
girl, love the way you're grooving. If you keep on dancing, then my marriage is gonna be ruined.
Catch me in the VIP.
Yo, hello viewers. You already know who it is. Pizza Kid, eh? Keep watching iRAP TV on the dot. Over, over. Yeah, I'm all about it.
Watari mi upana wa yami ye Mitampua wa yami mwani ye Watu wenye simebuzu ye Izu ya uza wa mumami ya Oh Ayase uza dadi ya tarie Nasuma ya mintumye uu Waya uza kwa kronkronu Ukami ya na uu wa mami Mitampu mitampu chedami na minkwa Watari mi ududu tise sumari Nasamiji ya siye kumeza sori Minsuro uu ya uwanzi Mitampu wa
Shorty, how you doing? I came over to tell you that I like the way you're moving.
Yeah,
girl, love the way you're grooving. If you keep on dancing, then my marriage is gonna be ruined.
Catch me in the VIP.
Still live on iRAP TV's exclusive interview with the professor, Africa's greatest boxer of all time, 2004 Boxing Hall of Fame inductee. Ladies and gentlemen, just a few days ago in Las Vegas, he was crowned as the greatest super featherweight boxer of all time. And from now on, just be on the lookout because any super featherweight championship belt will have his face on it.
Shorty, how you doing? I came over.
We're told that was a fight with Sanchez here at Madison Square Garden. And days before the fight, you couldn't find your mouthpiece. What happened?
A lot of things happens, you know. When I got to New York, and they gave me a swim partner who I spy with, and the guy went and told them that, hey, the guy is very strong, so the champion should be careful. And Don King was afraid, you know. So because Don King told the guy that, listen, you're the one you're gonna fight. It's not, you know, it's not coming, you know, it pull out. So we're gonna get you some African boxer, and this African boxer, just don't stop him the first round. Just take him to the third round and knock him out. You know. It's very easy for
him. So he thought he was going to meet some easy opponents.
That's right, you know. So until I came and I sparred with that guy, and the guy went and told them that, hey, this guy is so strong. So they give me one of the Salvador Sanchez spam partners to come and try what they are saying is true. And then when he came, and after I spar with him, he went back and said, man, you are in trouble. this guy is dangerous, you know. And then Don King was afraid. And he asked the manager who brought me, Mickey Dow, that's his name. And he said, why did you brought somebody like this? You know? And Mr. Dow said, don't worry, you know what I'm doing. So when the day for the fight, I couldn't find my mouthpiece, you know, I thought he's the one who took the mouthpiece. So we have to go to the store and pick one of the amateur mouthpiece and put in the water, and then I put in my mouthpiece. It's too big, you know, so I have to take a blade. Because we are in a hurry, we're fighting that night, you know, so I have to get a blade and cut it. You know, and when you cut the rubber, you know, the mouth was
it's rough
and it's strong. So in between the fight, you know, in the sixth round, he threw some left hook, you know, and he got me with on the mouth. So I have a big cut in my mouth, you know.
Bleeding,
you know, and I'm not ready. So I'm tired too, you know, but I mean, as a warrior, you always have to.
But that was the beginning of national and international recognition. That's when the world realized that there is somebody in Africa called Azumah. Yes. And now nobody was ready to fight you.
After I fought some of the fighters, nobody was ready to fight for 2 years. You know? So for the title, I was supposed to fight for the title for 2 years, and the champions, nobody wanted to fight for him. So I said, okay, I have to wait for the mandatory defense. So when we got to the mandatory defense, you know, they said we want the fight to be in Puerto Rico. Mm. The champions
were Fredo Gomez.
So I said, don't worry. So I was in the camp sometimes training, and then when the press comes and I start with me, I told them they should tell Gomez that I'm coming to take the title. They should train hard, you know. And then we went to, I remember when the fight came on, we went to a press conference, and then the Minister of Sports, Mr. Amaka Matafi, was there, you know, and they asked the guy.
That's Gomez.
Gomez asked him, I said, I'm going to take the title. How did he say it? He said, oh, you shouldn't worry. He knows that Ghanaians, we are hungry.
And that was 1984?
Yes, 1984.
And Ghana was going through some very difficult times. Right.
And he said, he knows that Ghanaians are hungry, but after this fight, they will be hungry more. And then the Amaka Matthew, the minister, said,
you hear what he said? Did you hear what he said?
And I said, yes. Did you hear what I said? And I'm saying to myself, ah, yes. The guy said that. What can I say? And then I realized that he wanted me to say something. And I said, don't worry. Don't worry. I heard what he said. Don't worry. He'll pay for it. Mm-hmm. So okay, yes. And I realized that is what he wanted to hear. You know. So when we enter into the ring, we start the first round. We're fighting that first, second, third, fourth, and then I'm putting pressure on him, and then I can see that he starts getting tired, you know, until like the 10th round or the 11th round, I think Amaka Matthew came to the corner and he said, Chilok Bishin, you know, and before he turned to his seat, I pushed this guy down, you know, and then he turned and come with the speed and jump the ring and come and carry me, you know, and before the Ghanaian start coming holding me, and it was fantastic. So that is when I became the champion, you know, and I said to myself, yes, now I'm the super killer, I'm the featherweight champion of the world. Whoever I think is a man,
she's
gonna take
it. Oh my goodness.
Johnny, how you doing? I came over to tell you that I like the way you're moving.
Yeah,
girl, love the way you're grooving. If you keep on dancing, then my marriage is gonna be ruined.
Catch me in the VIP.
Enjoy some great boxing history here on iRAP TV. We'll go for a break. We'll be back with more.
Turn your back, run it down. Go sideways, £4,000. Unis size everywhere you go, you spot them in team. One more me, but one more damn. Bah! Oya dami, yeah. Sisi mundi, we are dami, yeah.
ma won ti mi ara we mi su mi ara we mi ara we
would you got me alphabetry
aku
would you got me alphabetry
nana
would you got me alphabetry
aku
would you got me alphabetry
nana
alphabetry
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 push
alphabetry I no go turn them down.
Ish.
I love my diva.
Hey.
I no go turn them down. She sweet like sugar. Mm-hmm.
Still live on iRAP TV's exclusive interview with the professor.
Yeah. Girl, love the way you grooving. If you keep on dancing, my marriage is gonna be ruined.
Catch me in the VIP.
Welcome back. You're still live on iRAP TV. My name is Yaw Sakyi, and I'm bringing you an exclusive interview with the only professor in boxing history. From Ghana and from Africa, Africa's pride, Professor Azumah, Zoom Nelson. So we move on with conversation, and now let's talk about what you're doing now. I mean, you've not been active in boxing since 1998. We hear you're doing a lot of charity projects back in Ghana. You're supporting the deprived communities and building schools through your Azumah Nelson Foundation. Would you be kind enough to tell us a bit more about the foundation and how people who are watching us who want to reach out and want to be a part of what you're doing for Africa can be part of the process?
Yes, you know, right now I retired from boxing for a couple of years now, and I'm concentrating on charity work now. We bought like 50 acre land, you know, we build a complex with a boxing gym, football park, school, where to learn how to trade, you know, a couple of things, you know, basketball, other things. You know, but at the moment we are at the Eastern region. The name is Enoma Papem. I can mention that name.
Enoma Papem.
Enoma Papem. Okay. And we are building a school, six classroom block of school and toilets, you know, for them. You know, that's what we are doing right now. You know, so.
You're a man of an unblemished, you know, credibility. People have a lot of respect for you, and I know that millions of people watching across the world now who are listening to this interview and hearing you talk about the foundation would want to be a part of it. Is there any way we can reach you, the websites or?
Yes. I mean, you go to the web, you go to the site,
Azumah Nelson Foundation. org.gh.
Yeah,
I just wanted to be sure. So it's Azumah Nelson Foundation.org.gh, and people can follow and get to know more details about your foundation and how they can be a part of it.
That's right.
Shorty, how you doing? I came over to tell you that I like the way you're moving.
Yeah,
girl, love the way you're grooving. If you keep on dancing, then my marriage is gonna be ruined.
Catch me in the VIP.
Enjoy some great boxing history here on iRAP TV. We'll go for a break. We'll be back with more.
Yeah. Open your eyes. Open your eyes. Greetings arise. Yeah, better look with your eyes. Said I wanna die on the street. Yeah, them red I'm be born at me. Yo, my cues at the crabby street. YVP and I run at me. Yo, so we are know this is all up. And them no want if we go strong. But we not go slow down. No, we not. So we no listen when them talk about. We no sing spans for. No. We no respond. Try to catch you anywhere from a distance. You think we fear the trouble? No, we no. Send when I rumble at the jungle. But we no respond. Dream for the holiday. Listen, we no rant. Thanks, give thanks to how we live long. We make you think we die every day. I sing song. Open your eyes. Open your eyes, the need is arise, yeah, they're done.
Shorty, how you doing? I came over to tell you that I like the way you're moving.
Yeah,
girl, love the way you're grooving. If you keep on dancing, then my marriage is gonna be ruined.
Catch me in the VIP.
I'm Azumah Nelson. You're watching iRAP TV. Don't change the channel.
Now let's talk about your book. A lot of people walk through this earth without documenting what they've done. and so rich knowledge and ideas go wasted. But you decided to document your life, and we're told that the professor launched in Australia, launched in Ghana, and was recently launched in Las Vegas, is doing very well. What is in the book?
Well, the book is Azumah Nelson, from his childhood to his end of the box, his end of the boxing career. You know, when you need to get one copy, you need to get a copy of this book. You know, he tells you my life, you know, my good times, my bad times, you know, when I'm a bad boy, when I'm a good boy.
Tell us about, you know, one of your bad things that you did.
You know, couple things, like I can go to my grandmother's place. I'll be in my grandmother's place, and like I can, if I'm hungry, I'll take some bottles, you know. I have a big bottles, and I'll take the bottles, I'll go to the market,
sell them,
and then when I get the money, I come and share some money for my friends, and then they should go and find something to eat, you know. And one day I was a world champion, and the old lady that I've been selling the bottles for, she saw me, and then I saw her. I'm in my Mercedes Benz, mm-hmm. you know, with my driver and sitting back, you know, and I saw the old lady. I told the driver to stop. And when the driver stopped, I got down and then I went to the old lady. I said, "Ma'am, how are you?" And the old lady said, "Oh, my son, it's a long time. I saw you are not bringing the thing anymore." I said, "You're not bringing the bottles anymore." "No. Ma, right now."
Yes,
right
now, you're
right now, I'm a big boy.
And this woman used to sell bottles too.
That's right.
My goodness.
Right. So I left, and then the following day I came, you know, and I have money with a bunch of money, you know, and I went there and I gave it to her at the market. And as when I was coming, people are shouting, you know, "Hey, Zuma, and the old lady sitting down, and she don't know what is going on. And they said, what is happening? The champion, and when I got there and I give her the money, I said, "Mom, I'm coming to give you money, so take this money." You know, and the money is too, a lot of money. So he just hold the money, and she was so shocked. I said, Oh, that's my son. That's what I'll see you, Mom, and I just left, you know. So I'm happy to, you know, be with, you know, see somebody like, you know, old lady like that, and, you know, she still remember me when mm-hmm. I was
selling bottles,
you know, selling coconut and all kind of things.
We're told that your son is boxing now.
Yeah.
Junior Azumah Nelson. When will he be ready for the world market?
Well, I want him to go to the Olympic Games, because the Olympic medal is what I want to get, and I couldn't. So I'm making sure that my son can achieve what I couldn't achieve. So after the Olympic Games, he became professional, and then...
How do you see him? Do you think he has that tenacity? Does he have that charisma? The brave Azumah Nelson, does he possess these attributes?
Yeah, I'll tell you, I'm a professor in boxing. Mm-hmm. If I can get that, like 20 boys here, small boys here, and I put them in the gloves to fight, you know, for just 5 seconds, I'll tell you, this guy will be a champion. This guy will be a champion. I'll select all the champions. And when you train them, they're going to be a champions. And then I know my son is going to be a champion.
Great.
And great. If he's not going to be a champion, I'm not going to waste my time and waste his time.
Okay.
Shorty, how you doing? I came over to tell you that I like the way you're moving.
Yeah,
girl, love the way you're grooving. If you keep on dancing, then my marriage is going to be ruined.
Catch me in the VIP.
Enjoy some great boxing history here on iRAP TV. We'll go for a break. We'll be back with more.
Last two.
me de me gari berry delay. Macro. Se u be fia me ye buffet. E ye be ma dia me da pute. And then why ye lucky today? Lucky today. E ka me ye wa bibi today. A to friend kwe kubile. Wale ende di mugu go pay. Mugu go pay.
This is not a circus.
Chale beat the jalai hammer. Chale, hey, chale. Chika tane konga do file. Eye ne de we win the case. One Gloria Kufu e bookie date. Fuck for him. Mama ne fuck. I can ni plate. And I is a crew. I say wa me bobo day.
Me bo cafe.
Umbo me lega me bo cafe. Se wo ye takashia e no away.
How you doing? I came over to tell you that I like the way you're moving.
Yeah,
girl, love the way you're groovin'. If you keep on dancing, then my marriage is gonna be ruined.
Catch me in the VIP.
High grade.
I'm finna ya start and see ya di baby bro nyaye.
Bro nyaye.
Ya no mre sufra butre swa butre ko kenyaye.
Kenyaye.
I'm finna ya start and see ya di baby bro nyaye.
Bro nyaye.
Ya no mre sufra butre swa butre ko kenyaye.
Kenyaye.
Wanga Zongo Barao,
he's cooking.
Aruba Fiskan Lago,
he's cooking.
Achireido, Achireido. Take Malan,
he's cooking.
Wanga Zongo Barao,
he's cooking.
Aruba Fiskan Lago,
he's cooking.
Achireido, Achireido. Moisafi, Wallahi, take Malan, no fit to lie we. Cause Almighty not deny we. So we tell Babylon, don't try we. We are God blessed. In everything we put God first. See it and them a worship them a God bless. No let them day. What we a make go another one day. Ooh. Tell them go on and this if them want this. Cause the last time you check me still around this. Duba, Drake Marlon,
he's cooking.
Wanga Zongo Barao,
he's cooking.
Aruba Fiskan Lago,
he's cooking. Yeah.
Achireido,
yeah.
Achireido.
Yeah.
Drake Marlon,
he's cooking.
Wanga Zongo Barao,
he's cooking.
Aruba Fiskan Lago,
he's cooking.
Achireido, Achireido. Asko Papa na Papa, Siko Pao. You want dance with the beat go down. Yeah, the baby bro nyaye.
Bro nyaye.
Asko pampa na pampa, sicko pow. You want dance with the beat go down. Achireido, yeah, the baby bro nyaye. From BC we run the zongo. No time for no empty conco. Like the banja, they love the conco. The conco. From BC we run the zongo. No time for no empty conco. Like the banja, they run the conco. Hey, me and
Shorty, how you doing? I came over to tell you that I like the way you're moving.
Yeah,
girl, love the way you're grooving. If you keep on dancing, then my marriage is gonna be ruined.
Catch me in the VIP.
Enjoy some great boxing history here on iRAP. Now let's wrap up this conversation with your recent award, your honor that you received in Las Vegas.
It makes me feel proud. It makes me feel proud that all that I was doing before I was doing the boxing, and people are telling you that this one is the best. So when they call your world, when they call you, and they tell you that you are the one of the best of all times. And it's a good thing. So I tell you, give glory to God. You know, and I thank all, I always like to thank all my fans, you know, especially Ghanaians, Africans, you know, for their support. You know, because I know it's not because of them, I'm telling you,
this will be possible.
I cannot get there.
And we're told that you've been also be appointed the Ghana Boxing Ambassador. What are you going to be doing for boxing in the country?
You know, yes, the minister called me a couple weeks ago, two months or 1 month ago, and they gave me this letter, you know, and I said, Boxing Ambassador in the country. Yeah, and now boxing is going down every time. And if I believe if they follow what they say, I can promise them that God give us the life, you know. I can promise them 3 years to come, I'll change the face of boxing in Ghana. People will love boxing more.
And we were told last night you were honored back in Ghana, even though you're in the state, by the Sun newspaper as the 2014 Personality Service for Humanity Award. Congratulations. And also several awards that we're told that all over the world is being poured on you. We say congratulations to you. What do you want to tell Ghanaians and your fans watching?
Thank you, my son. I can't stop thanking Ghanaians. I can't stop thanking Africans, you know, because I always, and I know, and I have the feelings that it's in. Because, you know, boxing, not the star boxing, not today, you know, but in my time, everybody can witness, but when I'm going to fight, nobody sleeps. Why? You know, nobody sleeps because they want to see me win, you know, and I do everything for them, you know, I do everything, you know, the effort, the training, the focus, the power that I have, everything I put it in so that I can win, so that I can make them happy. Because they are there and they waiting for me to see me winning and praying for me, you know, praying for somebody. You see, if somebody give me money and somebody pray for me, I'll thank the one who pray for me more. So I would be prayers following me up to today. I always say God bless them, whatever they have lost, us with them.
Thank you very much, Professor, for your time. So iRAP TV, these are the takeaways. So the professor is officially the greatest super featherweight boxer of all time, conferred on him by the WBC. Professor last night was honored as the 2014 Personality Service to Humanity Award. Professor has been appointed the Ghana Boxing Ambassador. Professor has a foundation called the Azumah Nelson Foundation that you can reach out to him, be a part of the process to transform the lives of the deprived in the Ghanaian society. You can reach them on azumahnelsonfoundation.org.gh. Professor tells us that he's preparing his son to take the world stage. Are you ready to see the junior Azumah Nelson? And many, 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 many excellent and laudable projects that Azumah Nelson is engaged in. So I want to say thank you very much for allowing us into your homes. It's been an exclusive interview with the Professor Azumah Nelson on iRAP TV. The exclusive host for today, my name is Yaw Sakyi. Steve Kelly is here. Shim is here, Lamea and Wes. Lil Bill is here as well. So it's a whole house, it's a packed house, and it's special because of the professor. Zoom Nelson. Shout out to you. Out.
Want a new friend, a new